Hey everyone, it's Marina. I am going to do the long overdue craft room tour. But first, I'm going to show you what a mess it is. I guess it's not totally torn apart. I mean, some people's craft room are just like, wow. But to me, it's unorganized, so I need to clean it up. And I'm going to show you before and after. We'll even explain a few things beforehand, that way you're like, okay, that's what that is. So that is my craft desk right now. I have my little mini journals, my music, my headphones, all my stuff over here, which I'll go into later, but this is basically the mess that's going on when I craft. Yeah, there's lots of stuff down there. And then over here, just stuff all over. That mess down there happened because my lovely son, my youngest son, came in here and dumped it all out. I like to make my craft stuff. So,
Thomas says, stay home, get away from me, saying I was bad for you. He got his way. I'm gone for good. Making up stories, keeping it secret, taking your word for truth. You were bad for me.
I'm still so
done cleaning up, and I'm gonna go ahead and share it with you. Okay. My floor is squeaky, just ignore it. It's like an old building, so, or not an old building, it's an old apartment. So I'll start over here. I'm gonna turn this around, hopefully that helps a little bit. Okay, so up here, can't really, there we go, that's better. So up there is all of the journals that I got from swaps and the ones that I've used. And then right here is my A4 paper right there. That's my art journal over there. My potion bottle that I made. My pen pal book. These are canvas board. And back there are my baby books. And that folder right there is all of my art that I did when I was a kid, which I'll have to take pictures of and show you guys. Okay, so here is my, my kits that I have cut out and already dyed and just did all that that's already. Right here is one of my books that I want to start using for my family. Here is my journal that I got from a swap with, Teresa Winterburn. Hi, Teresa. And, oh, that's the next journal I'm going to use. I haven't used it yet. I have my stuff over there that I'm putting there. I'm just afraid I'm going to make it into a crocodile mouth. Down there is all of my Tyvek that I got from the post office, so I can use it in journals. And then this one right here is like all of my cases. It has my, or that's for my light reflectors and all that stuff. There is my lightweight chipboard down there and my grunge board, and then my card stock is right there. And then, of course, there's a cinch back there. Same paint brushes and sponges, and then in the bags is old newspapers, old magazine, Western magazines, and some paint in the red bag. Okay, so here is my altar shelf, everything that could be altered, except for that over there. That basket has my my crochet hooks in it and everything. Here is the paints that my sister used and put back. I don't know if you guys have ever seen Penny Dreadful, but it is one of my favorite shows, and I went ahead and got some of her tarot cards because that show's amazing, and I love the art. I love the whole thing. So, here is my paints, my spray paints back there. I have that skull plate back there. I was going to do something with it. That's from a tablet. I wanted to alter it. Those are my art journals back there in the corner. Like my deconstructed art journals. Here's some paint markers, some tape, my punches and my staplers and my hole punchers and all that. My 6x6 and 8x8 paper pads. And then there's my jelly plate that I just hung up on the wall. These are all my paper stacks. Well, not all of them. Actually, you'll see some of them hung up on the wall. These are my paper collections. I have some back there and back there. And then up here is a basket of yarn and then a big old bucket of yarn because I was on a crocheting craze a while ago. So I'm going to open up this other side. Oh. That is one of my kids' favorite movies, and I got them a pillow for the movie, and I actually got them two. They each had their own pillow, and then they ripped up the other one, and this one has a hole in it, so they like to pull the stuffing out because, I don't know, it's their autistic thing that they like to do. They like to, if something's messed up, they notice, and they'll just pick at it until it comes apart. So all my acrylic paints, or my artist professional paints, are on the wall over here. I have my re-inkers right there. All of my stamping pads. This is my art box. My sister likes to do her art over here. In this drawer is my incense and my candles. And then over here is my Marion Smith Color Lab kits. I have a light here, but I'm not using it. So my incense, and then in these drawers are my dried herbs, which I need to get some more of my seeds because I will show you guys my garden later, but my garden is looking fantastic. It's the first garden I've ever really had, so I'm really happy about it. Ouch. Sorry. Let's see what's in here. This, I think, is my junk drawer. I can't remember. Yeah, this is my junk drawer. And then down here is my themed pack stuff, and then I have napkins, tissue paper, and these things. I forgot what they're called. So that's all in here. Alright, and that is my window. This is where I do all my videos. I put this by the window originally because I was hoping the sun would come in here and it'd be all bright and stuff, but yeah. The sun comes right in, so I have that right there. In case it gets too bright, I can just put that in front of the window, which I never am able to film during, hardly ever able to film during the day, so I haven't had to use it yet. By the way, guys, just a little tip. This Otlight was $162, okay? And so I'm a little bit upset about it because to me, that's not very bright. I ended up getting photography lights, I want to get a ring lamp next because, I don't know, I was asking them the difference between the lights and nobody at the store knew, so I kind of just had to figure this out on my own. And so I have these two lights And then my other Ott light over here, and that one over there, it was like $60-something on sale because normally it was like $100. So anyway, back to room tour. Over here, I have just stuff. This is my son's school pictures. My other two haven't had school pictures yet, so. This is a candle from Crafty Irina. Hi, Irene. And this is some sand my little sister brought from California, plus down here. She put it in a container for me. And there's a whole bunch of shells in there. This is for my mom, her last visit. And then my Hawaiian sand and shells is downstairs on the bookshelf. So this is my son Xander's teddy bear from when he was a baby. And these are the roses I got from my fiance for my birthday. All right, so, I think I told you I made these dolls a long time ago. This one plays music. Or it used to. I'm not sure if it still does. I haven't tried it in forever. Okay, so I have some dyes in here. This top drawer has dyes. And this one has, like, stuff for textures. Like, I wanted this stuff for in here is for stenciling and anything that'll help with the texture, basically. Or hand-dyed seam bindings in here. Sorry, silk ribbons in here. There's some twine in here. My ribbon drawer. Just a mess, but that's my ribbon drawer. Like, I used to have everything looking all pretty, but yeah. Here is my fabrics. This is okay. This is a muslin that I got from Amazon. Oh, I can't remember. But they gave me 2 yards of it, I think. That's a lot of muslin, though. I have just all my fabrics in here. And I do need to reorganize these drawers. Down here is my leathers. I have leathers that I cut up from a jacket, some that I bought from Hobby Lobby, and they're all different colors. Down here is my tool. I need to use more of that. I just don't know what to use that for most of the time. Kind of my miscellaneous drawer. Just a bunch of everything in there. So there's ribbon, there's just lots of little stuff, confetti. Here's my bag drawer. So I have all my bags in here. Ones that were gifted to me. And then just ones I'm going to use in journals, stuff when I send stuff out, stickers, all of my stickers. So the pretty ones, the themed ones, the gems, all in here. All right, so here we have the glitter in the back, which is right here. Oh, awesome. We have alcohol inks, which I don't use as much as I used to. Then I have my embossing powders, and I used to have my patinas in here, but I use them so much I took them out. And then, of course, I have Marion Smith's Bloom Impressions, which I haven't used more than once. And up here is my microflakes and other stuff, and I guess the paints, acrylic paints. My stamps, cling stamps are in here. These are all my dyes that were gifted to me, ones that I cut out, and things that have been embossed, just in here. My envelopes. So I took a whole bunch out so I could dye them. So these are ones that have been gifted to me, ones that I bought myself, just all my envelopes. And my hardcover, or my wood mounted stamps are in here. All right, so we've gone through 4 so far. We have one more. And then, so here's my washi tape collection. Here's the banana hanger that I used when I'm doing Chunky Charms. And I left this out. This is from Lori, just a girl from the Bay. Hi, Lori. And I left this out so I would use it as soon as I get the chance. Like, I want to use it so it's in my face all the time. I want to make a Valentine's Day themed journal. So, and here is my laces, trims, doilies, and fibers. Some fibers that were gifted to me. They're all in here. This is my flowers, my moss collection. I went ahead and put some shells in there because I had those. Yeah, I'm making a mess with this. But here's all my flowers, ones I haven't dyed, ones I need to dye, or these are the ones that I have dyed and I put together. And then down here is all of my paper stuff, like all my paper junk. Yep. I have books in there so I can alter those. Some of them are, one of them's old, two of them are old actually, and the other one is kind of not old at all, but so it's more sturdy, not brittle. And then this little section is my junk stuff. So I have a whole bunch of junk in there that I can use, stuff that I've saved from like when I go to the store or whatever. Labels and stuff. Like these are journal covers I made out of boxes, items that were gifted to me. So I have all these in here so I can use them in journals. My printer. And then down there is paper, a big paper box just full of copy paper, printer paper. And inside the box is like some camera inside there. And I have this up here because I'm still using this for a project. Copy dyed papers over here. I have current, what is that? I just said it. Tyvek. The Tyvek envelopes over there so I can cut them up whenever I want to. When I get done making my tags, I put them up and I hang them over here. So after I'm done cutting all of them out, I hang them up over here and I have them by size. As you can tell, my larger mediums are gone. My clipboard that I have all of my information that I need to keep or fill out or something. That's the bag I got from Joann's. It's so cute. There's one of my chunky charms. And this one was gifted to me. So up here is my Graphic 45 Steampunk Debutante paper collection. Like one that I don't use. And then I have all the ones that were pages and stuff that were gifted to me are here. And so I've been using this one because I want to use all the stuff that was gifted to me. Plus I got this in that collection and I took it out and went ahead and used this with stuff. So it's just mixed up with ones that were gifted to me, ones that were purchased, all of that's in there. So I don't know if you guys have heard of Luthien Thai. I hope I said her name right. She is an amazing artist, and so I got one of her very expensive Beyond Time mixed media DVDs. So I'm working on that. I actually haven't been working on it for a while. I need to finish. So I just leave that there because I'm not done with it. I think I've done that with a few things because I really do intend to finish. Here is my jewelry, metals, jewelry stuff. My charms aren't in here actually. Some of them are, like the old ones are in here. These are a collection of fibers and stuff that I purchased from Etsy. My clays are in here, which I haven't worked with a lot at all. I just got them. And then my beads and stuff are in here. So, I don't have a huge collection of beads, but you really don't need a lot of beads to make pretty stuff. As long as you have a few different ones, you're good to go. I have... This is my paper clips collection over here. I have my little tiny flowers that I keep in here. And then in here is, I haven't really done anything with that yet. And that's where all my glue sticks go. Sorry. Okay, so here, this is my craft stand, or not my craft stand. My painting stand, like, so when I want to paint, I have a stand that I can put my canvas on. And that big old roll right there is a big old canvas roll. It's huge, you guys. It's really huge. And I have it for those over there so I can make my own canvas. Let's go under the desk. So my big shot's down here. I have a book back here. My scoreboard, my cutting mat. Over here is some of my tape for when I send out mail. Of course that, and it's all my paint, some of my paint stuff right there. And then my medium weight chipboard. And I have my kids' Dr. Seuss books and little tiny kid books back there that I plan to turn into actual books. Or journals, children junk journals. Here's some tags I need to make. This is paper I'm still using on a journal. Okay. My cinch binding rings, some tags that I can alter. That came with Kathy Orta's holiday kit that I was supposed to use in a mini album I never made because, I don't know, things got crazy and I didn't get the chance to make it. This is some really pretty paper that I super love and I want to use. I'm just afraid to use it because I don't know if they have any more. I have to look it up. This is what I want to use for summer. This is because I want to make something colorful, so I hung it up in front of me. And of course this one, because I've been wanting this one forever. I finally got it. I don't know when I'm going to use it, but it's there. So I just have little tool things that I put up here because I don't know what to do with them yet. This is my desk. Let me give you guys a bigger shot. So this is my desk. And here is my distress inks and the main stuff that I use when I'm crafting. My alcohol ink pads are in here too. My stamp stuff. All that's in here. And then there's my glue. And my drawers over here have eyelets, rings, which I haven't made a ring journal in forever. Lots of buttons. I think I have like four drawers of buttons. Put corners that I ordered on eBay a while back. Let's see if we can turn that. There we go. And here is corners. And then keys. Those are my charms. Gears and clock related items. The plates. Screws and bolts and nuts. And these are jewelry pieces or pieces that came off, like just main things that I want to use for something at some point. And these are like chains and knickknacks that were gifted to me. Same, or this over here is Brad's. I can alter these if I want to or use them. I end up using them half the time. Just cabochons and stuff in there. These are stuff that I've done something to and never ended up using. So like, this one was bronze and I made it silver, and he did have another blue piece in his eye, but it fell out, so. These are my silver pieces. More silver pieces. Kind of just like, these are, I don't know, they're little tiny filigrees, I guess. Charms from Tim Holtz. Box corners. I haven't got to use those yet, but I want to. These were gifted to me. Those are, I'm not sure if they're resin or acrylic. Then my little eyes or pearls that I got. Rhinestones. Flatback rhinestones. Just miscellaneous stuff in here. These are my elastic and my sewing thread. And this is my book binding wax linen thread, which I'm out. I used to have like 4 or 5 in here. My needles are in there. Please tell me what it is. I did, okay. Glass jars and containers. Gosh. These are for, you know, we want to put stuff in. I forgot what they're called. Marion Smith Junk and Gems, and all that stuff's in there. These are my Butterbee Scraps collection stuff. These are ones down here that are rusted. Just pieces that I'm going to use from Butterbee Scrap Store. This is my miscellaneous wood area. Yeah. Oh, these are my closures. Most of this stuff in here is closures. Down here is some more Butterbee Scraps items. Yeah. And these are my letters and numbers and stuff. And then down here is all of my distress stuff. Wow, that took quite a while. Okay, so up here is just, I guess I could use this as sinew right here, and then some post-it notes. Smaller eyelets and the wide eyelets. My clay stuff and my tools. These are for my cutting. My cutting tools are in here, and my fountain pen. And then my little mini distress inks are in here. And here is my wax seal kits, and I think some stamps. Oops, let's move that. And here is my, hold on. Yeah, this is my Velcro photo corners, glue dots, and foam squares. And all my baggies are in there, bottle caps down here. And then this over here is just for my notes. I'm not going to open it because it'll fall out. Oh, and then I have distress crayons there. Have only used the black one. Haven't really used that yet. This was gifted to me by Ange, so I just have this here for my stick pens. And then my distressor Sculpty bead making set or kit. Over here is where I've hung the jewelry that I made. That's for my Halloween thing. I really liked it. Over here is all of my inks and mixed media type stuff. Like here's my, what do you call this? Oh my gosh, you guys, I can't remember what it's called right now. So I have Pearl X over here, and then I have Perfect Pearls, and I have Ink of Gold. I have Glimmer Mist, Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist. I have my own Glimmer Mist that I've made. And then I have the Walnut Inks, of course, which I haven't used for a while. I have Stamp Cleaner, Ink Refresher. This is actually 24-hour makeup. It's called Tattoo Makeup. And by my Maybelline, I think? Yeah. Eye Studio, Color Tattoo. I've been using it for crafts. And here's my Gilder's Paste. Stickles are over here. Embossing powder, some of it's over here, and my patinas. All down there is my mixed media stuff, like texture paste, gesso, crackle paint, crackle texture paste, you know, stuff like that. Here are the two shelves for the items that are in my shop. So, except for that down there. Those books down there in the corner, those are Neil Gaiman's, is his Sandman series, which I super love. So yeah, I think that, I forgot this. This is my kids' art area, and that's from Janae, my sister, so I put that up too. And then, yep. So that's the little art that they made me, and they made more than that, but this is the ones that I've hung up. And I think I pretty much covered everything. So, if you made it all the way to the end, thank you so much for watching. And I will see you guys next time. If you have any questions on my setup or any tips on how I could, you know, improve my setup or make things more organized, feel free to leave those in the comment section. I'd love to hear from you guys. All right, I will see you guys later. Have a good one, everyone. Bye. So kiss this one more time.